Good morning, students. Today we shall revise writing paragraphs. Though you have been writing those paragraphs right from your middle classes, but still you must revise and remember that an analytical paragraph is a paragraph writing skill or writing skill which is a descriptive form of writing. It is a descriptive form of writing which is written on the basis of charts or the data given, graph, data, chart. The information is given through those part of our informative system, chart, paragraph, pie charts, bar graph, ठीक है, clues. अगर हमें कुछ क्लूज दिए हुए हैं उनकी बेसिस पर, मीन्स इफ वी गेट द डेटा थ्रू चार्ट, पाई चार्ट, ग्राफ, बार ग्राफ, वट एवर इट इज, वी आर गिवन द डेटा एंड इंफॉर्मेशन एंड देन वी डिराइव एंड डिस्क्राइब द सेंटेंसेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ दोज डेटा गिवन, ओके, एंड ड्रॉइंग the conclusion with the help of those data. Okay, when we write an analytical paragraph, which is an important part of our writing skill which is mentioned in our syllabus, one should remember to describe the facts which are to be needed. We have to describe only facts. We don't need to add information on our own part. Okay, then the paragraph must be clear and crisp. Clear hona chahiye, crisp hona chahiye. We don't need to add any other information. We should use clear and easy language. Complete details of the data must also be provided. Okay, so this is all about analytical paragraph. An analytical paragraph is a form of descriptive writing which is written on the basis of given chart, graph, data, outline, clue, tables. It requires analysis and comparison of the given facts and drawing conclusions based on the given data. So we need to take care of certain points. It describes the given chart, table, data, graph, cues, etc. It should be brief and comprehensive, but at the same time include complete information. It should state the fact that are provided. It should have simple and accurate language. It should mention figures and quantities appropriately. We should use the same tense throughout. Remember this. This is the most important aspect of a paragraph as far as possible. It should not provide any personal observation or response. It should preferably use the passive forms of the verb. Remember. This is, now we come to the format. It requires an introductory paragraph, means two or three lines max. Okay, introduction is one or two lines about the subject or the graph given. Then comes body of the paragraph, and in third paragraph it includes conclusion. Third paragraph includes conclusion. So introduction in one or two lines of the subject. Then comes body. What is it about? Use relevant figures, explain trends, make comparisons and contrast, divide in sub paragraphs if required, but don't make more paragraphs than three. only first, second and third. Second paragraph contains body, okay, then conclusion, third paragraph. This is a simple exercise for you, so have a look at this. This is a division of household task by gender in Great Britain. क्या क्या काम मेल और फीमेल्स करते हैं, कुकिंग, बेकिंग, वॉशिंग एटसेट्रा, क्लीनिंग हाउस, टाइंग, टाइडिंग एटसेट्रा, गार्डनिंग, पेट केयर, केयर ऑफ टाउन ओन एंड चिल्ड्रन एंड प्ले, मेंटेनेंस एंड और जॉब्स, देन क्लोथ्स वॉशिंग, आयरनिंग एंड सुइंग. सो दिस इज द job distribution means household task by gender in Great Britain. This is the paragraph for how it is developed. In first paragraph we have written, the chart shows the number of minutes per day spent by British men and women in doing household task. On an average, the women spend about 4 hours during doing household task, whereas men spend less than 2.5 hours. It is a general conclusion of all the household activities. Okay, then we come to the distribution of work one by one. The task on which women spend more time than men include cooking, cleaning house, taking care of the children and laundry. In doing these tasks, women spend approximately 200 minutes, which is almost 3 times the time spent by men in these tasks. On the other hand, men spend twice the time than women in doing tasks like gardening and maintenance of odd jobs in the house. Means we don't need to add of our own. Whatever the information is given, we have to write in the form of sentences. That's all. Okay. So on the other hand, men spend time twice the time than women in doing the task like gardening and maintenance of odd jobs in the house. Men spend the highest time, almost 50 minutes, in gardening and pet care, while the women spend only 30 minutes for these tasks. The time spent by men in washing, ironing, and sewing clothes is as low as 2 minutes per day, as opposed to 25 minutes spent by women. Now the concluding paragraph. In short, women spend far more time doing household chores than men, whilst men prefer to do gardening, pet care and maintaining odd jobs. Okay, so this is all about this writing paragraph. I have given you this one more exercise for you. Okay, this is a pie chart for, so this is all about paragraph. Okay.